Are you getting blurry photos like this, even when you're using a flash? Today we're going to talk about flash duration and why it's such an important concept for photographers to understand.
The big misconception that photographers have about flash units is that when you trigger the flash, it fires instantaneously. But in reality, what's happening inside your flash unit is that the flash tube turns on and off, almost like it's powered with a dimmer switch. It takes time for that flash tube to ramp up the power to full output and then to turn off again. Flash duration is the measurement of how long it takes for that flash tube to turn on and off. It's simply a measurement of time. We usually list it as a fraction because photographers really love fractions, but it'd be far less confusing if we just listed in how many milliseconds it took. For example, 1/333 of a second equals 3 milliseconds. Both are measurements of time. That flash duration will be different depending on two things: the quality of the flash unit that you are using and the power output of that flash unit. Generally speaking, the more expensive the flash unit, the shorter the flash duration. And secondly, the lower the power output, the shorter the flash duration. Higher quality lights generally have a shorter flash duration and cost more than lower quality lights that have a longer flash duration and cost less. Here's another illustration. We're going to use this aperture light to simulate a flash tube that goes off in both a short and a long flash duration so that you can see the difference between the two. In this first example, we're going to illustrate a short flash duration. Notice how quickly the light turns on and off and how it just freezes the subject for just a fraction of a moment. Now let's show you what a long flash duration looks like. Notice how much more movement we can see because the light is on for a longer period of time. It's because the light is on for a longer period of time that you see blur in the image.
Hopefully this explains what flash duration actually is, but why do you need to understand this principle? Well, if you take photos of things that don't move, like simple portraits or turtles or flowers or student photographers, maybe even social media influencers, it shouldn't matter. Understanding flash duration becomes essential when you're photographing things that move. The faster they move, the more you need to worry about flash duration. Here we have an Elenchrome 400EX and a Profoto D2. We're going to use these two lights to photograph a swinging baseball bat at the exact same power output. Now, in both instances, the camera is going to be synced with a shutter speed of 1/200 of a second. But remember, it isn't the shutter speed that's freezing the subject, but rather it's the flash duration of the lights. The Profoto is freezing the subject with a flash duration of 1/4000th of a second, which equals 0.25 milliseconds. But the Elenchrome is only firing at the flash duration of 1/323 of a second, which equals 3.09 milliseconds. Because the Elenchrome flash tube is taking 12 times longer to turn on and off, you are going to see blur in the bat. This is the biggest problem with a long flash duration. It can't freeze action. Whatever part of the image is moving the fastest is where you're going to most likely see the blur. Simply put, if one light is on for 1/4 millisecond and the other one is on for 4 milliseconds, which one is most likely to be blurred? This is why flash duration matters. You need short enough of a flash duration to freeze the subjects in motion. You can use a light meter like the Seconic Speedmaster L855DU to measure the flash duration of your lights. And it will even give you a graph that shows the intensity of the light from the beginning of the flash cycle up to full output and then back down until the flash tube turns off. On this flash duration chart, T5 is a measurement of the amount of time it takes for the flash unit to ramp all the way up to full power and then back down until 50% of the light has been dissipated from the flash tube. Manufacturers like to use T5 measurements when marketing their equipment because T5 makes their flash durations appear shorter than they really are. But in reality, you have this whole tail here end of the image that is going to cause blur. T1 is a measurement of the time from the beginning of the flash up to full power and then back down until 90% of the light has been dissipated from the flash tube. T1 is a far more accurate measurement of flash duration than T5. If you don't have a light meter, you can usually find the data from the manufacturer of the lights on their website. Just pay attention to which T scale they're using. What can you do if your flash duration just isn't fast enough for the photos you're trying to capture? Well, there's a few things. First of all, you need to maximize the flash duration of your flash unit. We had already showed you that generally speaking, the lower the power output of the unit, the faster the flash duration. Find the lowest power output that you can use and still successfully get the shot, which may mean that you have to increase your ISO or open up your aperture. You could also double or triple pack your lights at a lower power output to maximize that flash duration. For example, instead of using one light at full power, maybe use two lights at half power. You'll have the same overall output, but at a shorter flash duration. When you use multiple modifiers such as softboxes or silks, every single modifier that you use reduces the amount of wattage that actually makes it to your subject. So maybe think about using fewer modifiers or taking off some diffusion to maximize the power output of that flash unit. You could also move your lights closer to the subject, and that will help you maximize the flash output at that flash duration. Guys, I know that's a lot of information to digest, but it's really important. Understanding flash duration will make you a better photographer. If you have any questions for us, go ahead and throw them in the comments below. And otherwise, we'll see you on the sidelines.